Nexus provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Good evening, Jira.
Yeah.
I have a quick question.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to, your project, the one that you created for the JSPN service,
okay.
It's not showing up on the core. What do? I right-click and validate? Is that
no,
all I do?
It's not on the core. It's you'll be having a separate folder the way you have the JDBC in Core Java. You have the similar kind of folder also in there. If I go to my GIT, and if I just expand these, if you see, we have already spoken about Core Java, JDBC, and you will be having something like Servlet Web Pro. Okay?
browser.
No, no, it'll be on your desktop. It'll save it in the in your local system. Okay. Alright, so let's move ahead and we'll talk about a couple of other options today. We'll talk about filters today. Okay, we'll talk about exceptions also, how to handle exceptions. Alright. Now, what happens basically till date, what we have seen, MS Paint. Till now, what we have seen, this is your browser and this is your actual server. Okay. Your request basically comes from your browser to your server. Okay. And ultimately, you get a response back. Right. Now, what happens is I want to do some kind of filtering saying that. Now, see, server is all common. Now, you might be having multiple browsers and anyone can access your particular server, okay? But what I want to do is I want to have some kind of filters in between your, even before coming to your actual page. Now, when I say actual page out here, now here when you say hello.html and you give hello form, now what is, which particular servlet is going to take your request? That is nothing but your hello form here. Okay, so the request, let's say the request directly come from your HTML page to your hello form somewhere which is present in your server itself. Okay, so request comes up out here. But even before even getting into it, I want to basically add a filter in between, saying that I want to do some logging mechanism. I want to do some checks. Let's say I want to if you have a user ID and password. You are entering your user ID and password and you are checking whether your user ID and password doesn't match us, you can basically stop that request. Now, when I say request, the request is this request which goes to your actual servlet. So, this request I will stop in order to go into this. Instead, I will first come to this filter. This filter is going to, if everything goes fine, this filter is going to send your request to your actual servlet. Okay. So here in this case, we have added a couple of filters. Now let us talk about authentication filter here. Now if you see authentication filter, it is as it is a filter, you have to implement that to a filter. Okay. So it is again an interface out here. Okay. Now as you know, for a servlet, it has got its own lifecycle. Now even your filter has got its own lifecycles also. Okay. It has got its destroy method, it has got its init method, and it has got its, let's say this is a service method. So this is the method which is going to take up all the requests first, and if everything goes fine, it is going to do a chain.do filter. Now if you see, the do filter is going to take three parameters. One is your request, response, and chain. Now chaining means what? If everything goes fine, if this, the request which is coming to the filter, if everything is fine, your validation is done, then it sends the request back to your actual servlet. Okay, if anything goes wrong, I want to give some other response back to the user. Okay. So that is what is present out here. If you see here, I'm saying here if, okay. So first let's see what is the filter out here. And the first time the request comes up and you are just checking the IP address out here. Okay, I'm just checking what is the IP address and just printing it out here. And at last I'm just doing a chain.do filter. Okay, so let us clear this up. And let me access this. So when I do a submit out here, even before that, let me go back to the servlet and just change the content type to text HTML. Okay. Now if you guys, if you can see here, everything, all the HTML tags are present out here. Okay, I mean you can do anything. You can even embed a JavaScript also. So JavaScript ultimately goes back to your browser. Okay. Now come to the filter, and what did I do here? I'm just printing the IP address of this particular system. So how do I get the IP address? I just say request.getRemoteAddress. Now why it is remote address? Because let's say you are accessing my system or accessing my server. So in that case, I want to get your IP address. Okay, as it is request. Now you will ask me the server is running in your own system. But actually in real time, the server will be running somewhere in globally. So you can access your server from anywhere. Okay. So that is what the actual use of it. Okay. Now here, the very first time you start your server, first time if you see, your authentication filter is getting invoked. Okay. That means it
question here.
Yeah.
When you say that only when you say hello, then it will be this filter will be executed only for those servlet names which have hello in
it's
it.
Not the servlet names. If you see, I can say here as web servlet web pro slash hello slash. So for that case, I have to create a folder out here, right? Somewhere in this, I will be creating a folder, new folder, and let's say this is my, let's say tags. Okay, so in my tags, I have got a page as hello.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
So
correct.
How do you access?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
I got it. Where we give the URL pattern. I got it. My question is that for each and every URL pattern, this both the filters will be executed
as of now because I've given a star here. Okay.
Okay.
But let's say
so
you're
whatever we do, whatever we do, it will be executed like.
Whatever
we
you do.
Give it only once.
Yeah,
I mean
this will be given only once.
Yeah, this will be given once, but the filters will run every time.
Every
right?
time it is going to run. Okay.
Okay.
Because see,
okay.
My purpose is that because when I talk about authentication filter, whoever is accessing my server, they have to go through a filter process. For that reason, I'm just giving it as a star here. Okay. You can even have your own URL pattern. Let's say you are having something like tax filter. Now. Your application has got a tax application. Your server has got, let's say, sports application.